Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do, shaboom. Life could be a dream. If I could take you up in paradise up above. If you could tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open for me again, boom. Ding dong, ding dong, lang, lang, lang. Oh, 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 clip. But oh, but if, oh, life could be a dream. If only all my precious plans would come true. Then you would let me spend my whole life loving you. Life.
What was the button? Was it 6? Was it 9? Was it 0? Options. No. Controls. Boost. It was 8. It was 8. Hey, there it is! I win! Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. We just hit 100 subscribers, and there's a question that no one's asked me many times before. What's your favorite tank? Well, if I had to choose a favorite premium tank, it would be the T-29, but if I had to choose a second place, it would be the T-55AM-1. It's Spookston approved, Oddbuzz approved, Floppy played it once, and with all that praise, I decided to buy the pack. And I don't regret it. In the past, I've spent money on War Thunder and then immediately realized that I just wasted that money. But the T-55 has paid itself off. At least that's what I tell myself. The first thing I did with my brand new tank was buy the skin and swag it out. I mean, you got to. And then I played a game. I did all right. You know, nothing special. We weren't expecting something crazy from game one, right? I kept playing and getting more comfortable with the AM-1 and started having some really good games. Look, getting a good game isn't really about skill. It's all luck. Just do your best, and every time you queue into a match, you either roll a good game or a bad game, even if you're still playing your best. But there is one way to improve. If you want to take your gaming to the next level, then you should read up on the stats, or, you know, watch the next 4 minutes, because that's all it takes. As you move up in the battle rating, you begin to realize that armor becomes less and less important. It's really more of an afterthought. You can't really angle or hold W without consequence like you can at lower BRs. Up here, people know how to play the game, and they want their points, whatever it takes. The best thing to do is just to assume that everything can kill you, and probably in one shot. Battle rating tank doctrine switches from having so much armor that you end up just eating enemy shells for breakfast to the onion. Don't be seen. Don't be hit. Don't be killed. Just stop doing that. And so the focus shifts from having good armor to having the better gun and the faster engine. I know I just said that armor isn't great, but on this tank, it's not really that bad. The T-55AM-1's armor works great against everything except APFSDS, HeatFS, and ATGMs, which is what most people will be using anyway. The upper front plate and lower front plate both have 100mm of rolled homogeneous armor with another 30mm of RHA on the upper front plate. The turret face has about 130 to 200mm of RHA. The T-55AM-1 doesn't really have a mantlet, but it has extra composite armor on the cheeks. The composite armor is made out of rolled homogeneous armor, metal polymer blocks, and cast homogeneous armor. These armored blocks are able to stop all heat and ATGM rounds from doing any significant damage. The sides have 80mm of armor, and the turret has about 90 to 160mm of armor. The turret and upper front plate are very strong, with the lower front plate being the clear weak spot. The T-55AM-1 is equipped with the 100mm D10 T2S cannon. The AM-1 also has a two-plane stabilizer and a laser rangefinder. The turret rotation is pretty slow at only 14 degrees per second, so when you fly around a corner, the stabilizer will keep up, but then slowly rotate back towards the center. The T-55AM-1 has night vision, but no thermals. Hopefully you don't get stuck in a night battle. I haven't. Yet.
Ooh. What?
This is disgusting. The AM-1 also has a roof-mounted MG, which is always nice to have. The gun sounds really cool and it does some decent damage, but you only have a handful of bullets before it has to reload. That's really all there is to the gun. Oh, yeah. T-55 has access to many different types of ammo to bring into a game. Actually, it's only missing HESH and APCR, but most of them are viable options. We'll start with my favorite pick, the BR-412D. It is an APC-BC shot, but it's just so good! Anything it pens, it kills. The small nuke from the APC-BC shot is only helped by the 100mm caliber. The explosions are very rewarding. And speaking of explosions, this thing launches ATGMs. For newer players, ATGMs are so exciting because they're late game weapons. For everyone else, they're slower than shells, can get eaten by random debris, and get stuck on volumetric armor, doing very little damage. But hey, if you want to load up on missiles and drive out onto the battlefield, still not a bad option. I really only have the ATGMs just in case there's a helicopter that gets a little too close. The 3BM-25 has 335mm of pen. The darts have a high velocity that makes aiming easier, but with the rangefinder, I still prefer the APC-BC over the APFSDS. If you've never used a laser rangefinder before and don't know anything about it, I'll give you a little tutorial. Bind a key to rangefind. Press it. I find that crew members are more spaced out at this battle rating, and one-shotting with the darts can be difficult, especially against light tanks. But it's still useful to have if you run into something with heavy armor. And again, it's completely viable to bring this out as your main ammo. The AM-1 also has APDS and Heat FS, but those seem more like background choices that would help progress through the modifications if it weren't already premium. There's also a smoke shell, but the T-55AM-1 has smoke launchers and ESS, so why even bring the shells? The mobility on the T-55AM-1 is downright incredible. Coming in at just over 41 tons with a power plant of 690 horsepower, this tank will get to the battlefield faster than most. It has a top speed of 45 kilometers per hour, but in just moments it'll be going 30. It takes some time driving in a straight line to hit 45, so on larger maps or roads you can get up to the top speed, but usually you won't be going faster than 40. The pack costs $60, and you get the tank, 2000 GE, and 15 days of premium time. I recommend spending the GE on crew points if your crew level is somewhere less than 40 or 50. For 1000 Golden Eagles, you get 17,500 crew points that you can spend. You can make your tank reload faster, accelerate and brake better, traverse its turret faster, change crew members quicker, and lower repair times. The T-55AM-1 is rank 6, so it can effectively research any tank in the Russian tech tree for the full RP reward. The T-55AM-1 is extremely versatile. It can go anywhere, it can shoot anything, at any range, and it can sometimes bounce incoming rounds. The T-55AM-1 is fun to play. No. Keep backing up. It's at a higher battle rating, and if you've never played up at 8.3 before, the transition will be rough. It might sound rude and condescending to say that high-level premiums are locked behind a skill barrier, but they are! If you want something fun that earns money and you've never played around 8.3, then consider spending your money elsewhere. Having premium time never hurts. I purchased this to help me grind the Russian tech tree well after I hit 9.7 in the US tech tree. So if you're prepared for the battle rating, then this tank is a fantastic option for grinding the Russian tech tree. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. If there's anything that you want me to cover in Warthunder, let me know down in the comments, and as always, bye bye.